everybody. My name is Krisztina Tóth. I'm a writer. I live in Budapest. And now I would like to share a story with you from my childhood. We lived with my parents in a huge high-rise estate in a new era of Budapest. In the 70s, that was probably the first big residential of high-rise panel flats, and half of the residential was under construction, the other half was already built. We had our flat on the 7th floor with a nice wide view on those large empty green fields. Otherwise, it was quite interesting to be a child there. We loved to watch enormous cranes and trucks coming around and working with huge concrete blocks, and we loved to play together and get in big pits and to scrape for some clay to create small items from the mud. So it was nice. One day, a television broadcast presented the freshly opened new supermarket of the district. That was the first big supermarket of Hungary with an automatic conveyor belt at the checkout. That was the modern technology. We were extremely excited and we went to see the new supermarket. We could not resist to play with the automatic belt, and we put baskets on it, and it was interesting to see that it worked by itself. Opposite of this new supermarket, there was a round square with the usual concrete furniture designed for this place. That became a traditional meeting point of local people, local inhabitants, and elderly people coming from small villages who had a great difficulty to adapt to this new lifestyle spent their time sitting on those concrete benches. One day, our classmaster sent a written message to students' parents. It was in September, I remember very well. That was the end of our holiday. So we received this letter, and that was the year in fifth class when we started to learn a new subject, the biology. I was really excited to start the biology. The first lesson was about the petunia. The petunia is a common plant, easy to find everywhere, almost in a village, but not there. Our teacher wanted to demonstrate the plant structure and to show us under a microscope the different parts of the petunia, the stamen, the pistil, and all those boring things. So, instead of a bacterium or something interesting, we were supposed to enter in the world of microscopic wonders by a simple petunia. My mother, as usual, managed to find the right strategy to find a plant. My parents, during the Sunday dinner, were thinking to elaborate the right strategy to have a petunia. "We have to get up early," said my mother. "We have to go to the main square because there were huge concrete flower beds. They were probably installed for the television broadcast and for the opening ceremony." And she remembered very well having seen some petunia inside. So we got up at 5 o'clock. It was a fresh dawn of September, and we went to the supermarket. It was a dark dawn, and we were creeping over the flower beds to steal a plant. And at this moment, we realized that the huge concrete beds was already ruined and completely empty. There was not a single plant to be found anymore. There were about 100,000 new inhabitants in this part of the city at the time, and other parents had probably the same bright idea to find a plant. So at 6 o'clock morning, it was really too late. Now I'm over 50, and every time when I see a petunia, I remember of this story. I didn't become a biologist, but a writer, but still I'm interested in microscopic details of the life.